Honda safety has always been priority, so with the introduction of Honda Sensing, nobody was really surprised. But what exactly are you getting with Honda Sensing, and what am I paying for?
Honda Sensing
was dreamed up and created because Honda wants to get even closer to a collision-free world. Sure, Honda wants to protect the lives of the passengers and drivers of their cars and motorcycles, but Honda actually creates their technology to help protect the pedestrians as well. How cool is that? The pursuit of a collision-free society is a part of Honda's global safety concept, safety for everyone. Honda Sensing is a system consisting of two types of sensors with different characteristics. One is a millimeter wave radar located inside the front grille, and the other is a monocular camera mounted on the upper inside part of the windshield. With further improvement in performance, the new millimeter wave radar expanded its scope of detection to include pedestrians, regarded as being hard to detect due to their low rate of radio wave reflection, as well as the position and speed of target object. Moreover, the monocular camera identifies attributes and sizes of pedestrians and other target objects which come in range with approximately 60 meters ahead of the vehicle, achieving recognition with improved accuracy. With the significant improvement in the precision of these sensing devices, six new functions, such as the pedestrian collision mitigation steering system, the world's first, were added to the existing driver assistive system, not yet available in the U.S. To accommodate these versatile functions, the data processing capability of the system has improved. The system now recognizes not only its surroundings, but also the intentions of the driver and conditions of the vehicle, and applies collaborative control over certain components of the vehicle, including the braking system and the steering wheel. In the areas of vehicle speed, following distance control, and lane keeping control, the system assists the driver during normal driving as well as in risk avoidance maneuver in case of an emergency. Honda has long been committed to the development of various driver assistive technologies to support safe and comfortable driving of many customers. Honda will continue evolving its advanced driver assistive technologies on a global basis, adding the newly developed Honda Sensing to further improve the safety and comfort of its products. Lane departure warning, or LDW, can detect unindicated lane departures from detected lanes. Alerts will flash and sound to help bring your attention to correcting the lane drift. Lane Keeping Assist System, LKAS, can reduce driver fatigue by helping to keep you in the middle of your lane. If you begin to leave the center of a detected lane without signaling, the steering adjusts to keep you centered. Road Departure Mitigation, RDM. If your vehicle is drifting too close to the side of the detected roadway while driving 45 to 90 miles per hour without a turn signal activated, RDM alerts you with rapid vibrations on the steering wheel. If you continue to leave the roadway, it can also apply steering torque and braking to help keep your vehicle in the detected lane. Adaptive Cruise Control, ACC, helps you maintain a set following interval so you don't have to manually change your speed. Forward Collision Warning, FCW, integrated with the Collision Mitigation Braking System, FCW uses a small camera mounted at the top of the front windshield to detect the presence of vehicles in front of you. If the FCW system determines that you are at risk of a collision with a detected vehicle, it indicates audio and visual alerts to warn you. If you fail to act, the collision mitigation braking system will automatically apply brake pressure. Collision Mitigation Braking System, CMBS, utilizing a millimeter wave radar sensor, CMBS, can help bring your Honda to a stop when the system determines that a collision with a vehicle detected in front of you is unavoidable. First, a warning sounds, and if necessary, brake pressure is automatically applied. Hey guys, so here we are inside a Honda Accord with the Honda Sensing. The buttons. That is the road departure mitigation. And let's keep that bad boy on. Okay. Next one, the forward collision warning. As indicated with the little car crashing, it's right there. Braking system is on. We like that. And at the top, you can see the ACC, which is your adaptive cruise control, and then LKAS, lane keeping assist system. Basically, they are all tied in with each other. That button allows you to change the distance. Between you and the car you're following. So I set cruise control. Do I want to follow that close? Or I want a little bit closer? A little bit closer. And do I want to ride their bumper? So there's that. There it is. And also with the adaptive cruise and lane keeping assist together, the world is happy and we don't wreck. At least, well, that's the idea. And if you are following a car, a little car will pop up right there and kind of have a little car like that. Like an, it'll have an outline of a car if the car moves, and if a car comes in right in front of you, it will it'll fill in. So then you go to, you can go to your settings, your vehicle, and that is all part of your driver assist system. And then we can go to setup, forward collision warning, adaptive cruise. So do we want it to beep at us? Why not? So adaptive cruise, pre-running car, detect beep, yes. Change the display of speed, miles per hour, of course, because we're not in Canada. Would you like to set ACC display auto? Yeah, yes, yeah, okay. Road departure mitigation setting, what can we do there? Normal, wide, warning only. So, kind of obvious. We'll leave it at normal. Lane keeping assist system, suspend, beep. Well, would you like to set lane keeping assist? Yeah, I like the beeps, so let's keep a beep. So, there you go, guys.